So welcome to the next chord, the diminished seventh chord. It's used for a lot of things. The way I tend to use it very often is to use it as a connecting chord, which can actually take itself to a lot of other chords, which are dominant in nature. And then those dominant chords can go to different scales. So it's like a chord which has four notes. And each of those four notes can be adjusted to take you to four different scales, you know. So let's just explore all of this with E diminished seventh. How do we build it? Root, minor third, another minor third, or the tritone as we popularly call, and essentially another minor third. So that's three stacks of minor thirds. Little spooky if you think about it, if you just play it as it is, on its own a very nice sound, you know. In fact, if you go chromatically, you can get some very interesting flavors, right? So that's one application, I guess. I don't use it that way, you know, in my music. The way I use this is now, you could look at this as the starting chord. Then you could drop any one of these fingers by one semitone or one half step. Let's say I drop the first note to, what chord does it form? It forms a dominant seventh. This is E flat dom seventh, right? So you go, and where does E flat want to take us to? It's a dominant of A flat major or A flat minor. So it's an incredible chord right there, isn't it? It's one diminished seventh taking you to its a dominant seventh a step apart, taking you to major or minor. So this way you have four ways of using the diminished chord. You could go, we took this down. You could also take the middle one. What happened there? G became F sharp. This is like an F sharp dominant seven. Resolves perfectly to B major. That's another scale, right? So far you have this one chord which is taking you scale 1, scale 2, scale 3, scale 4, four scales. So could do that, or or minor. The other thing now would be the third note, B flat, B flat. Bring that down. A seventh going to D. Okay, so or D minor. Okay, and the fourth way of resolving, what chord is that? That's C seventh, E diminished seventh. Drop the top note. I think I like this the most. So that's the diminished seventh chord. Again, I use it to kind of pass from one to the next to the next, or from this directly to the tonic. But you could also use it as it is, you know. Just move chromatically down or chromatically up, and you get this very kind of old school horror movie kind of sound. So you could use it as it is, or you could use it to compose music as a passing chord. Let's move on.